Praise God, we are gathered here again today. Good morning. Welcome to our worship. I hope you will stay with us and find yourselves giving God the glory and thanking Him for His faithfulness in all times. Let us give God the highest praise as we worship, and let us begin with these songs. Give thanks, and I will worship.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. I long to worship. worship. You alone are worthy of my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy of my praise.
Let us pray. As Jesus sent the disciples out into the communities, so we are sent to proclaim that the kingdom of heaven has drawn near. We are eager to share your love without expecting a reward. We realize we will not always be made welcome. When that happens, let us move on because there are many more places that need to receive your grace. May your Spirit speak through us in truth. Lord Jesus, equip us for the journey, we pray. Amen.
Our scripture reading is found in Romans 5, 1 to 8. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace, in which we stand and we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured in our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we still were sinners, Christ died for us. Matthew 9:35-38. Then Jesus went about all the cities and the villages, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them, because they were harassed and helpless like a sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." Then Jesus summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to cure every disease and every sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, also known as Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew, the tax collector, James, the son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus, Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, the one who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out with the following instructions: "Go nowhere among the Gentiles and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go, proclaim the good news. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You receive without payment, give without payment." The word of God for God's people. Thanks be to God.
For our song response, let us sing "Thy Word."
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I feel afraid and think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Let us prepare our hearts as we listen to a message through song by the Baluyot and Marker family. It is indeed a joy to have someone I know since I was in the Philippines. The Granadosan family has been a blessing in the life and ministry of our church, especially in our area, the Baguio Episcopal area, where I belonged. And they played a great role in my decision to become a pastor. And actually, Bishop Granadosan was the one who ordained me as an elder of the United Methodist Church of the Northwest Philippines Annual Conference. And I have come to know more of them in our district and conference gatherings, and especially when we have the best of our activities of our young people that we call Christmas Institute. And I tell you, Christmas Institute back in the Philippines are well attended. Hundreds of young people do come and be in that camp. Well, Edward was the youngest of six sons of the late Bishop Granadosan, and to Mommy, Mrs. Socorro Granadosan, who still can sing, is very active, very much involved in the church, still can conduct the choir, and praise God that she is still sharing what God has gifted her with. I never thought Edward will decide to become a pastor, but thanks be to God that he responded to God's call. I'm not going to go into the details of how he became a pastor. And without further ado, let us now listen to the message, a testimony of Brother Edward, Pastor Edward Granadosan of East Alton United Methodist Church, East Alton, Illinois.
Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. This is Pastor Edward Granadosan, and I bring you greetings from my home church here at East Alton First United Methodist Church. I would just like to take this opportunity to thank the Reverend Alexis Cambe for inviting me over to share a bit of the music and my life as a pastor now. I have known your pastor for since I was this small, smaller than him. But anyway, just a joke. But anyway, I would just like to share this song to all of you. And I hope and pray that you will be encouraged, especially in these times of pandemic. I know many of you are now going through some issues and problems, and the anxiety is kind of high. But thanks be to God, we have a Lord who is loving, who's always by our side, who's always in us, and allowing us to go through with this, not just us alone, but for Him to be always with us all the way, right? So I hope and pray that this song will touch your heart. God bless. Walk on through the rain. Well, the pastor said, tell something about myself. What will I say, pastor? But anyway, I am just so blessed because of the encouragement that God has given me with my family, with my friends, the life that I had before. It was all God's purpose for me to realize how important our lives are. At this point in my life, I am grateful. I did not really regret all those my past life, because God really showed me everything. I was living my life was in the entertainment world. I was an artist. I was a singer. I was a young, passionate performer during my time. Not only actually in the secular setting, but also in the gospel world, because I know some of you know that I was part of Papuri, and that is the arm, the ministry of 702 DJAS back in the Philippines. And my first recording was back in 1986, Jesus ang Lahat. Jesus is All to Me. That's the translation of that song. And since then, I was exposed to both worlds, you know. So I did met many celebrities in my time also, performed with the best Filipino entertainers and world-class entertainers. That's how I should describe my friends. But somehow there was always an emptiness in my heart. Sure, I was really getting paid very well. I was able to support my family very well, but the Lord was, you know, leading me to a different path. So when we moved here in the States back in 2003, we lived in California for almost 7 years. We stayed there. I moved my family from the Philippines, and then I did what I was doing in back home. I was also always performing, doing some backups for celebrities back home in the Philippines. But then California became so expensive, so we were looking for a new place to settle. And first I was planning to go to Seattle and live somewhere in near my brother, who's pastor now, Reverend Steve Granadosin, who was living then back in Seattle, Washington. Well, actually Redmond, Washington. But it didn't work out. So we looked for another place, and we saw Nevada. So we found Nevada very easy life, and it's not that expensive as compared to California. That's where the place where the Lord spoke to me. I was leading a church. Well, I was their musical director, and then suddenly I was preaching. Because the pastor was out, you know, I was conducting Bible study. I said, "What's going on?" every time I was reading the Bible, somehow it becomes alive in my mind. I don't know what's going on. So I asked a pastor friend of mine. I said, "Pastor, what's going on with me? It seems that the Word of God is becoming very, very much alive in my heart and in my mind, and I can express myself better from God's Word." So And then my my pastor friend said, "So, what are you doing now?" Well, actually, to be frank with you, I don't like to be a pastor because many people are saying, "You're going to be a pastor. You're going to be a pastor." I said, "No, I'm not. I don't like that life because I saw my dad's life." But then the pastor said, "You know what? I think God is calling you." I've been running away from the ministry. I just want to serve Him. That's it. But I don't want to be a pastor. But he said, "You know what? He's calling you. And if you keep on running away, something might happen." Okay. So that's where I decided back in, what year was that? I think 2009. Because we moved in California 2003. Yeah, 2009. We were planning to move to Nevada. So in 2010, that's where I said, "Okay, Lord, if you want me to be a pastor, then I'll do it. But be with me. Don't just stay by my side and help me out." And He did. And to this day, I've been so fulfilled in most especially in the ministry. And then I saw Pastor Alex one time in one church gathering, I think in somewhere there in Northern California, I saw him. And I said, "Pastor, you have grown." No, I'm just kidding. "Pastor, I missed you." and then he found that I was a pastor also. So he was thrilled. He was happy. So here you are. I am going through the process, of course, and hopefully I'll be an associate soon. But thanks be to God for really when you confess your sins to God, He is faithful and just to forgive your sins. And all the scriptures that I've been encountering is very much alive in my heart. "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him will not perish but have everlasting life." And all those powerful scripture writings that spoke to me and changed my heart. I believe that the Lord did not just bring you here in the church of Pastor Grace United Methodist Church here in San Francisco. You were here. You were called here to serve. You were called to, of course, to help your pastor and encourage him and be one body of Christ to tell the world that indeed Jesus Christ is the one who's going to redeem us from this pandemic world. So. That's why I am very much confident that He will always be with me, and He will always be with you, and He will always be with your pastor. So again, thank you very much for inviting me, and I hope that the Lord will just continue to use all of us to proclaim His word, either through music or through our lives. Even in our brokenness, God will still continue to use us, because that brokenness will be His message. This messed up life of ours will be His message to the world. Okay, so again, this song is for everyone, and may the peace of the Lord be always with you. God bless. This is Pastor Ed Granadosin.
Tomorrow morning, if you wake up and the sun does not appear, I will be here. If in the dark you lose sight of love, hold my hand and have no fear. I will be here. I will be here when you feel like being quiet, when you need to speak your mind. I will listen, and I will be here when the laughter turns to crying, through the winning and losing and trying, we'll be together. Tomorrow morning, if you wake up and the future isn't clear, I will be here. Just as sure as seasons are made for change, our lifetimes are made for war. I will be here. You can cry on my shoulder when the mirror tells us we're older. I will hold you, and I will be here to watch you grow in beauty and tell you all the things you are to me. I will be.
What a powerful message you shared to us this morning, Pastor Edward. What can we say but may God continue to bless you, your family, and your ministry, and hope and pray that through you a lot will be blessed and a lot will be brought to the Lord's kingdom. And now, as a response, let us now share our offerings, our pledges, our tithes, whatever way you express your love to the Lord. Let us now offer as we are being led by a gift of music. Let us now dedicate our offerings. Let us pray. Holy God, we marvel at your love for all your creation. When Jesus saw the crowds that gathered, he had compassion on them. And his ministry and the church that bears his name must always remember we were born out of compassion. We offer our gifts to continue the work of compassion, but more than this, we offer ourselves as he also commanded us to go. In his holy name we pray. Amen. And Jairus Kambe from San Francisco State University. Friends, let us be in a moment of silence and then we will pray together. Let us now pray for our graduates. Dear God, we pray for our graduates today and lift them before you. We thank you so much for this. We love and for the work you are continuing to do in their lives. They are a gift to us and to many others. We thank you in advance for all you have in store for this day, for this year, and for their lives. We ask for your wisdom and clear direction over their lives. that you would give them understanding beyond their years. We pray that you would direct their steps, that your plans for them would prosper, that every place you have determined for them to walk would be paved clear. We ask for you to open doors that need to be opened and close everyone that should be shut tight. Allow every gift and treasure you have placed inside their lives to grow, develop, and flourish to bring your glory. We ask that you would remind them every day how very much you love them, that they would find security and confidence fully in you, knowing that you are trustworthy and true. May you raise up greatness in their lives, greatness in this generation, willing to stand strong and true, passionate for you, believing that you have designed them for purpose and good works, which you have planned and prepared in advance for them to do. Be a lamp for their feet and a light to their path. Shine over them. Fill them with your spirit. Bless them with your favor and peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, let us give them a big, big hand. Congratulations to you, graduates. God bless you all. I would like to invite all of you now to be in a community prayer, but before that, I'd like to specially mention a shout out loud to those who are having birthdays this week, and happy birthday to Sister Helen Flores, to Manang Carol Rosario, and to Sister Joyce Viloria Concepcion. And so with that, may God continue to bless you, and may you become examples of what it is to be faithful in the Lord. And also, I'd like to express on behalf of our church, our condolences to the Ignacio family, to Ate Nita, to Brother Manny Ignacio and family, to Brother Maynard Ignacio and family, and to Sister Mimi and family back in the Philippines. And for the passing away of Sister Myra just last Friday. And we would like to express our deepest condolences, that may God be their strength and their comfort as they grieve. And for that note, let us all be in a moment of silence as we pray, along with what is there in the screen, that may we include them in our prayer. For our closing hymn, let us sing Rescue the Perishing, and let us follow the one that is on the screen.
Rescue the perishing, care for kindness, chords that are broken will vibrate once more. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying. Jesus is merciful.
Brothers and sisters, receive the blessing. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you all until we meet again. Amen.